We're celebrating the anniversary of the very first jazz recording today, which happened on February 26th, 1917, almost 100 years ago. My first public performance was a recreation of many of these same recordings we'll be recreating today for the 70th anniversary of the first jazz recordings in 1987 at New York University. It was a concert that I conceived, produced, and for which I transcribed all of the recordings that we recreated that night and will be playing this afternoon. It was a memorable evening, and the concert was completely sold out, received a rave review in the New York Times by none other than John S. Wilson, and there was nowhere to go but down from there. Until today. Gotcha. The evolution of jazz, it's a controversial subject, and we're not going to get involved in a debate over who the first jazz musicians were or what constitutes jazz and what doesn't. There are many gray areas. We're here to play the music, and it's great music, and that's what this event is all about. So what we do know is that on the morning of February 26, 1917, the Victor Talking Machine Company brought in a band of five musicians from New Orleans to their new recording studios at 46 West 38th Street in Manhattan. They'd come to New York by way of Chicago a month earlier and had quickly become a sensation through their performances at Reisenweber's restaurant on Columbus Circle. They called themselves the Original Dixieland Jazz Band, and they played an exciting, fiery brand of music that was unlike anything else on record at that time, and which the public hadn't heard before. It might be worth pointing out that the word Dixieland in their name referred to their place of origin and not the music they played. It was maybe another 20 or 30 years before they started using the word Dixieland to apply to the music they played. And that was really not by the musicians. It was the mass marketing media machine that started using the word Dixieland to mean traditional jazz, to distinguish it from swing music and bebop and other forms of music that were developing at that time. So this is just days before the Russian Revolution, and while America herself simmered on the brink of war, the Victor Talking Machine Company recorded and released the world's first jazz phonograph record to an unsuspecting public. That record went on to sell over a million copies in a matter of months. It surpassed John Philip Sousa and Enrico Caruso, who were the top sellers at that time. And it really heralded a concurrent revolution in music. So today, we're going to take you back to that historic moment in time. We're going to delight your senses with those very first sounds that exalted a war-weary nation and propelled it into a wild, hypnotic frenzy, which would prevail for more than a decade. And that era became known as the Jazz Age. We're going to play a little bit of that original recording right now. This is Livery Stable Blues, and you'll hear why it's called Livery Stable Blues. This is the B-side of that first jazz recording, and recorded on February 26, 1917. This is how jazz sounded 100 years ago. Thank you.